Last Saturday afternoon, Iceland's Reykjanes volcano was seemingly on the verge of producing a brand new eruption within minutes to hours. I was even convinced that an eruption was imminent. However, only 126 minutes after the movement of magma began, it ceased and no eruption ended up occurring. This left many people confused, asking why an eruption did not occur and what exactly just happened. For reference, Iceland's Reykjanes volcano seemingly entered a highly active phase beginning on October 21st of 2023, which has been defined by the continuous filling of a magma chamber located approximately 1,100 meters south of the Svartsengi geothermal power plant at 5 kilometers or 3.1 miles depth. Additionally, here are the underground pathways overlaid if they were to have existed on the surface so you can understand what is occurring. Somewhat like a geyser, the aforementioned magma chamber is in a cycle where it fills at a rate of around 5 cubic meters per second until it reaches a specific threshold. This threshold has been decreasing as of late, but has historically ranged from 8 to 13 million cubic meters. After this volume is reached, magma will build in pressure until it forces its way outwards at a pre-existing weak spot which happens to direct at 4,300 meters to the east-northeast. This begins what is known as a magma run event. The volatile material and gases in the magma subsequently expand, propelling the magma upwards as it simultaneously expands along a separate and longer 15-kilometer long dike. You can track the motion of the magma somewhat roughly during this period as it creates an intense earthquake swarm. These earthquakes can then expand further to the northeast or southwest over time, sometimes both, either eventually reaching the surface at specific points or completely subsiding altogether. Since October 21st, the Reykjanes volcano has repeated the cycle I just described 5 times, and it is now entering its 6th cycle. 3 of these times resulted in a 30 to 50 hour long volcanic eruption, while the other 2 failed to reach the surface. With this taken into account, between 3:43 and 5:49 p.m. local time on March 2nd, the Reykjanes volcano experienced one such magma run. Earthquakes showed that magma expanded outwards along a 4.2 kilometer long trend until it suddenly stopped moving. The culprit for the lack of an eruption was that for an unknown reason, the magma chamber did not release all 8.8 million cubic meters of magma it was holding. Instead, it only released 1.34 million cubic meters, with this volume containing insufficient total gases and volatiles to propel the magma upwards to reach the surface and erupt. So, does this indicate that Reykjanes won't erupt for a fairly long time now? Sadly not, and the opposite is the case. Before the magma run began on March 2nd, it looked like an eruption was near certain in the next 0 to 1 days. Since 1.34 million cubic meters of magma was removed, if you consider the fact that the magma chamber is refilling at a rate of 419,000 cubic meters a day, then you will realize that it will only take another singular day, perhaps as high as 5 days, for the exact same series of events to likely repeat. This means that another magma run, perhaps even an eruption, is almost certain to occur between March 5th and March 9th. Yet, there is some more bad news. In the 15-kilometer dike, magma seemingly utilizes the weakest point in the entire length where it chooses to rise upwards. Because of the recent failed intrusion, the central 4.2-kilometer long section of this dike is essentially closed off to new material, being blocked by now-cooling magma. This suggests that any new magma run will either move molten rock further to the northeast or, in what is more likely, travel closer towards Grindavik and potentially even produce an eruption which mirrors the January 2024 eruption. Such an event would widen existing cracks that have cut through large swaths of the town and potentially create new ones. So, stay tuned for another high likelihood of an eruption occurring between this Tuesday and Saturday. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, Motorman Ted, for supporting this channel.